Well, hello, boys and girls, and welcome back to Storytime with Mr. S. I'll tell you what, I feel like a million bucks today because it is Friday, which means at school this week it is Dress for Success. Now, normally I dress like this, but that's okay. I hope you guys are somehow dressed a little fancy today, and if you're not, that's fine too, because being successful is sometimes a state of mind, and it doesn't necessarily mean you have to dress up nice to be successful. But today I thought it would be cool to put my shirt and tie back on. It is Friday. That means I want to give a special shout out to my Friday classes. That means hello, Miss Matelski's class. Hello, Mrs. Vidas's class. Hello, Miss Lori's class. Hello, Miss Cooney's class. And hello, Miss Farinella's class. Well, I thought it would be fun to read Duck for President. This was written by Caldecott winner Betsy Lewin, because, well, I mean, to be president is kind of successful, so I thought this would be a fun story for you today. So here we go. Let's check out Duck for President. Could you imagine if we had a duck for president? Okay. Running a farm is very hard work. At the end of each day, Farmer Brown is covered from head to toe in hay, horsehair, seeds, sprouts, feathers, filth, mud, muck, and coffee stains. He does not smell very good either. The animals have chores to do too. Pigs clean underneath the beds. Cows weed the garden. Sheep sweep the barn. Duck take out the trash, mow the lawn, and grind the coffee beans. Seems like Duck has a lot to do. At the end of each day, the pigs are covered in lint bunnies, the cows are covered in weeds, and the sheep is covered in dust. And Duck is covered in tiny bits of grass and espresso beans. Duck did not like to do the chores. He did not like picking tiny bits of grass and espresso beans out of his feathers. Why is Farmer Brown in charge anyway? Thought Duck. What we need is an election. So he made a sign and he hung it up in the barn. Farmer Brown must go. Farm election tomorrow. The next morning, Farmer Brown found a poster on his front door. Vote Duck for a kinder, gentler farm. Farmer Brown was furious. He ran to the barn and found the animals were registering to vote. Voter registration. Voters must live on the farm, have a valid ID, and be at least this tall. No, wait, we'll cross that one out. The mice got together and protested the height requirement, so Duck crossed it off. On election day, each of the animals filled out a ballot and placed it in a box. The vote was counted and the results were posted on the barn wall. It looks like Farmer Brown got 6 votes and Duck got 20 votes. Farmer Brown demanded a recount. One sticky ballot was found stuck to the bottom of a pig. The new tally was Farmer Brown 6, Duck 21. The voters had spoken. Duck was officially in charge. Running a farm is very hard work. At the end of each day, Duck was covered from head to toe in hay, horsehair, seeds, sprouts, feathers, filth, mud, muck, and coffee stains. Running a farm is no fun at all, thought Duck. So let me stop for a minute. Duck didn't like his few chores, right? He had 3 chores. So he decided he would put himself in charge. And what did he find? He found out that being in charge is sometimes very, very hard work. Do you think he's going to want to stay there, or do you think he's going to want to quit? Sometimes when you're in charge, you feel like you want to quit. That night, Duck and his staff started working on Duck's campaign for governor. Vote for me. I'm a duck, not a politician. Duck left Farmer Brown in charge and hit the campaign trail. He visited small-town diners. He marched in parades. He went to town meetings. He gave speeches that only other ducks could understand. On election day, voters filled out their ballots in booths all over the state. The vote was counted and the results were posted in the local paper. Duck wins by a nose. Wow, and this is the governor, the old governor, who's reading that. The governor demanded a recount. two sticky ballots were found stuck to the bottom of a plate of pancakes. The new tally was, Duck wins again. The voters had spoken. Duck was officially in charge. Running a state is very hard work. At the end of each day, Duck was covered from head to toe in hairspray, ink stains, scotch tape, fingerprints, mayonnaise, and coffee stains. And he had a very bad headache. Running a state is no fun at all, thought Duck. That night, Duck and his staff started working on posters for their presidential campaign. Duck for a change. I like Duck. Duck making us proud again. Duck left his staff in charge and hit the campaign trail. He kissed babies in the local diners. He rode in parades. He gave speeches that only other ducks could understand. He even played the saxophone on late-night television. On election day, the voters filled out their ballots in booths all over the country. The vote was counted. The results were announced on CNN. Duck wins again. The president demanded a recount. 10 sticky ballots were found stuck to the bottom of the vice president. The new tally, still Duck won. The voters had spoken. Duck was officially in charge. But running a country is very hard work. At the end of each day, Duck was covered from head to toe in face powder, paper cuts, staples, security badges, secret servant agents, and coffee stains. And he had a very bad headache. Running a country is no fun at all, thought Duck. Whew, I bet it's not. Then he checked the help wanted ads. Duck needed, no experience necessary, must be able to mow the lawn and grind coffee beans. That sounds like his chores from before. Duck left the vice president in charge and headed back to the farm. At the end of each day, Farmer Brown is now covered from head to toe in hay, horsehair, seed, sprouts, feathers, filth, mud, muck, and coffee stains. And Duck? Well, Duck is now working on his autobiography. And that, boys and girls, is the end of Duck for President. It was a silly but fun little story. I hope you enjoyed hearing it as much as I enjoyed reading it. Don't forget, you can check out my other videos on your Google Classroom page. And if for some reason you're not on my Google Classroom page, you can check my videos out on YouTube. The name of my page is Library Class at Home with Mr. S. I hope you enjoyed Duck for President, and I hope you are dressed for success. Have a good day, boys and girls. I will see you guys tomorrow.
Drop it. Sitting on kajillions. Have you met my friend, Benjamin? Looking as good.